Good evening, welcome to Northeast Web Shots. You are watching Northeast Web Shots Daily Evening Bulletin. This is Angel, starting off with national news. India's COVID-19 vaccination coverage crosses 95 crore 82 lakh mark. Northeast Frontier Railway has successfully completed the electrification work of 649 route kilometer. Railway Ministry has said that this will now connect all major cities of the country with Guwahati on seamless electric traction. Indian Railway has embarked upon an ambitious plan of electrification of its complete broad gauge network by 2023-24. Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Dr. Rajiv Kumar today launched the Niti Aayog United Nations Development Programme UNDP Handbook on Sustainable Urban Plastic Waste Management in New Delhi. Prime Minister Modi is set to launch first ever national infrastructure master plan called Pradhan Mantri Gati Shakti. This master plan will be launched on October 13, 2021. Gati Shakti scheme was launched with the aim of achieving three basic goals, namely seamless multimodal connectivity for facilitating easy movement of goods and people, improved prioritization, optimal uses of resources, timely creation of capacities, resolutions of issues like disjointed planning, standardization and clearance. Assam, a new master plan for Dibrugarh in Assam was unveiled on 12th of October, that is Monday, which poses to expand the area of the town and set up six satellite townships. Delhi, the CBI has registered an FIR against 3Max IT Infrastructure and Service Limited and its directors for allegedly cheating the State Bank of India-led consortium to the tune of over ₹862.06 crore between 2009 and 2017. Kerala, noted Malayalam film actor Nadumudi Venu died at a private hospital in Thiruvananthapuram on 11th of October while undergoing treatment of stomach-related ailments. They said he was 73. Maharashtra, CBI conducts searches at premises of ex-Maha Home Minister Anil Deshmukh. Allegations against Deshmukh had surfaced after the removal of Mumbai Police Commissioner Parambir Singh. Nagaland, Swarnim Vijay Mashal, or the victory flame that symbolizes India's victory over Pakistan in 1971, reached Nagaland capital Kohima from Dimapur on 11th of October. It was received by Inspector General of Assam Rifles North, Major General VPS Kaushik, with full military honors and placed at Kohima Garrison War Memorial. The leave of all Uttar Pradesh police personnel has been cancelled till October 18 in view of the upcoming festivals and programs scheduled by farmers body Samyukta Kishan Morcha SKM. Uttarakhand Transport Minister Yashpal Arya, his MLA son quit BJP, joined Congress. They joined the Congress in the presence of senior party leader Harish Rawat in New Delhi. Punjab, ahead of Punjab Assembly election in 2022, Delhi Chief Minister and Aam Aadmi Party AAP National Convener Arvind Kejriwal visited Punjab's Jalandhar today. Justice Satish Chandra Sharma was on Monday sworn in as the Chief Justice of Telangana High Court. The Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation GHMC is likely to reintroduce its one-time settlement OTS scheme on payment of property tax. It is ready to waive up to 90% of accumulated arrears on property tax provided taxpayers clear their entire dues until 2020-21 by just paying 10% of interest on overall due. The Telangana State Election Commission has planned to conduct a dry run of a mobile-based e-voting system. This system, if successful, will facilitate to vote using smartphones from home. Moving forward to defense news, the Chinese Army has not agreed to the constructive suggestions given by the Indian Army to resolve the remaining friction points or areas along the line of actual control LAC, and that is why the 13th round of talks concluded without any results, the Indian Army said in a statement. Indian Army Chief General M.M. Naravane arrived in Sri Lanka on 12th of October on a five-day goodwill visit at the invitation of his Sri Lankan counterpart General Savendra Silva. During his visit, General Naravane is expected to call on President Gotabaya Rajapaksa, who is the Commander-in-Chief of the Sri Lankan Armed Force, and Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa. Nuclear-powered US aircraft carrier Carl Vinson will be the part of the second phase of the high-voltage Malabar exercise from October 12 to 15, featuring the navies of all four Quad countries, India, the US, Australia and Japan. The exercise will take place in the Bay of Bengal and it will feature a number of complex drills involving several frontline warships and other assets of the four navies. The Indian Army will deploy its frontline warship INS Ranvijay and INS Satpura, a submarine and a fleet of P-8I long-range maritime patrol aircraft. The Defense Ministry has cleared deemed contracts worth Rs 65,000 crore for the 7 public sector units being carved out of the Ordnance Factory Board under a grandfathering clause, with the new entities set to be launched this week by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The new entities, which have been formed from 41 erstwhile OFV factories, will also get significant advance payments from the Defence Ministry, Central Armed Police Forces and state governments to help them move to a new corporatized structure. A junior commissioned officer, JCO, and four Jawans were martyred on 12th of October Monday during a fierce encounter between security forces and heavily armed terrorists in Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir. According to official sources, a gunfight with terrorists in villages close to Dara Ki Gali, DKG, in Surankoti area of Poonch district. Coming towards the international news, Prime Minister Modi participated in the G20 Extraordinary Leaders Summit in Afghanistan in virtual format today at the invitation of the Italian presidency of the G20. PM Modi had earlier participated in the SCO-CSTO Outreach Summit in Afghanistan. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar participated in the meeting of G20 foreign ministers in Afghanistan on the margins of the UN General Assembly in New York. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has embarked on a week-long US trip to attend the annual meet of the World Bank and IMF, as well as G20 finance ministers and central bank governors, FMCBG meeting. Minister of State for External Affairs Meenakshi Lekhi today addressed the high-level meeting to mark the 60th anniversary of Non-Aligned Movement, NAM, in Belgrade, Serbia. The Minister of State focused on contemporary issues of tackling the COVID-19 pandemic, terrorism and climate change. PM Modi, UK's Johnson speak as UK ends quarantine for vaccinated Indian travellers. Prime Minister Modi and Boris Johnson welcomed the progress made on the 2030 roadmap since it was agreed by the two leaders in May. Moving forward to world news, Thailand to end quarantine for some vaccinated visitors from November. Visitors from least 10 countries, including Britain, Singapore, Germany, China, and the United States, will be exempted from quarantine on arrival, according to a transcript of recorded televised speech provided by his office. 5-day-long Durga Puja celebrations begin in Bangladesh. More than 32,000 puja mandapas are made in Bangladesh this year. Dhaka has 238 mandapas. Puja celebration will end on 15th with immersion of Durga idol on Vijayadashami. Coming towards the sports news, IPL match, Kolkata Knight Riders beat Royal Challengers Bangalore by 4 wickets in the eliminator match at Sharjah. Ireland's Emmy Hunter becomes the youngest cricket player to score an international century by scoring 121 against Zimbabwe on her 16th birthday. Hunter overtook the record previously held by India's Mithali Raj. Coming towards the end, COVID update national, India saw the lowest daily rise in COVID cases since early March, as 14,313 fresh infections were lodged in the last 24 hours. 181 coronavirus patients died since yesterday, shows the government's data. The country has reported over 3.39 crore COVID cases so far and 4.5 lakh deaths since the start of the pandemic. Nearly 95.89 crore vaccine doses have been given in India so far. The government aims to fully vaccinate 108 crore people by the end of this year. Most states are trying to speed up vaccination drive. With this, we come to an end of today's news headlines. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Northeast Web Shots is also available in Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and YouTube. For more updates, keep watching Northeast Web Shots. This is Angel signing off for now. Good night.